Hey guys, today we're going to talk about how people listen to music through history. We're going to go backwards in time from today all the way back to the 1950s, starting with streaming. With more reliable internet and smartphones, streaming has become so popular, and it's given more people access to music than ever before. It's really a revolution in listening to music. Right before streaming became popular, downloading MP3s was one of the main ways people listened to music. You could download them from a CD or buy them on iTunes or on Amazon. A lot of MP3s people had came from CDs or compact discs, which a lot of people used to put files onto their computer and store their music. Here's what a CD looks like. You probably have some of these at home because they're still pretty popular today. I know I have a lot at school and a collection at home. Right before CDs, the 8-track and the cassette tape were popular. I don't have any at home to show you, but I did have cassette tapes when I was little. And that brings us to our main event, the vinyl record. The vinyl record was invented pretty early on in the 1900s, but it was perfected over time and remains popular even today as a format for listening to music. This is my turntable, and this is what you use to play records. It's called a turntable because it turns. Here's what a record looks like up close. If you look closely, you can see that there's rings going along the whole thing. Those rings are little grooves in the vinyl. This is the arm and the needle. The needle goes in between the grooves while the record is spinning, and that is how the music comes out. On this turntable, you can either press the start button and the arm will move over by itself, or you can drop the needle on yourself. When you pick up the arm, the record starts spinning, and you very gently... Ta-da! To take it off, you can either press the stop button, or just lift the needle. I'm gonna show you guys some of the records that I have, and then maybe we'll do a little freeze dance. The first one I wanna show you is The Wizard of Oz. When you haven't played a record for a long time, you wanna use the cleaning brush. So first we get it spinning, and gently brush. This will get any of the dust out of the grooves so that it doesn't mess it up when it's playing. So let's try pressing the start button this time. And the arm will move over. Next, I want to show you guys one of my favorite Styx albums. So this is side two of Pieces of Eight. Next, I thought that this Whitney Houston album would be kind of fun, so let's see what's on it. Oh. Ooh. All right, let's go.
Oh,